New York hosted the world premiere of the 8th and final season of HBO's Game of Thrones last night. Most of us, though, must wait patiently until mid-April for the first episode to air. In the meantime, HBO launched an epic scavenger hunt, hiding 6 replicas of the show's iconic Iron Throne around the world. The New York location was discovered when the official Game of Thrones Twitter teased a new city flying a starry banner seeks protection from the Great War. How far will you go for the throne? And from far they came.
Probably took me about four hours, and then we waited another 4 hours here. My friend Cassie has been following the throne around the world, and when she found out that it was here in New York City, I drove down from Boston last night to make it to here.
We actually, a friend of ours told us online, and we checked it out. We thought it was actually an April Fool's prank, but we don't think it is. We've seen people leaving, they look happy, we're excited.
People have been flocking to Fort Totten Park here in Queens to have a chance to sit on the Iron Throne. Since Thursday, the wait to see the throne has been up to 6 hours long, causing police to cut off the line on some days.
The show is a worldwide phenomenon, with new fans getting hooked every day.
It's freaking awesome, and I got sucked in super fast, like super fast. Everyone's like, oh, you're gonna be on the hook. First episode, and I'm like, I hate all the blonde people. I'm never gonna watch this again. Okay, one more. And next thing you know, I'm not sleeping. I'm going to work looking hungover. So yeah, that's what happened.
Henry Gwauman, on the other hand, says he's already watched the series 3 times in its entirety and would do anything for the throne.
I am actually missing school today. I have school in like 1 hour, but I don't think I'm leaving, because I'm gonna stay here until I get to the throne. It's gonna be a 5-hour wait from here to the actual throne.
Many who visited the Bayside Park dressed up as their favorite characters, while some took the role playing to the next level with dragon eggs and swords.
I own a chocolate shop here in Queens, and since the throne is in Queens, we decided to make dragon eggs to celebrate the final season of Game of Thrones. I read the books before the show came out, so yeah, it's been years and years. Yeah, 10 years, 12 years.
As these diehard fans wait the long hours to sit on the throne, it's the perfect location to trade fan theories.
I want Daenerys or Jon Stark to be on that Iron Throne at the end.
Cersei Lannister. She's gonna win. She's definitely gonna win. Cersei and Daenerys are the same people, all right? If you want to fight me, let's go. But they're the same. Y'all are rooting for the wrong person.
After all that waiting, guests only have 30 seconds to get the coveted Iron Throne picture. And it's estimated by the end of today, 5,800 to 6,000 guests will have sat on this throne. So after all that wait, was it even worth it?
Hell yeah. I've been watching the show for 9 years, so I finally got to sit on what I've been watching the last 9 years, so it's been awesome.
Yeah, it was super awesome, but it was like kind of intimidating because you're in this environment, you feel like you're in the crypt, you're on the throne, there's people in cosplay. It was mad exciting, yeah.
I had a friend of mine take pictures while I was sitting down. He took a lot of them, I'm so happy. It was really worth it.
It was really cool. It was a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
Other thrones around the world were spotted in Brazil, Spain, Canada, Sweden and the United Kingdom. Some fans even hiked 150 miles into the Arctic Circle in search for the throne.
This season will only have 6 episodes, the first airing on Sunday, April 14th on HBO.